This video is provided as supplementary material for courses taught at Howard Community College. And in this video, I'm going to talk about graphing exponential functions. And specifically, these are going to be functions where the base is a number between 0 and 1. I'll have a separate video where the base is some number greater than 1. Okay, so for the examples I'm going to use, I want to work with the function y equals 0.5 raised to the x, or you could say y equals 1/2 to the x. When the base of an exponential function is between 0 and 1, that function is going to be a decreasing function. In other words, going from left to right, it's going to curve downwards. So we know this is a decreasing function. The domain of any function is basically whatever x values we can put into the function. And since we can raise 0.5 to any number whatsoever, a positive number, a negative number, or 0, the domain will be all real numbers. So we can say the domain is from negative infinity to infinity. Now, no matter what number we use for the x value, 0.5 raised to that number is always going to be something positive. We can never make 0.5 to the x equal a negative number or a 0. So the range is going to be from 0 to infinity. Since we can never have this equal 0, but it can become a very, very small number, in other words, when x is very big, 0.5 or 1/2 raised to that big number is going to be a very small fraction. That means we're going to have an asymptote at y equals 0. It will get very close to the x-axis, but it won't touch it. And we can figure out what the y-intercept would be. The y-intercept happens when you have an x value of 0. So 0.5 to the 0 power is going to be 1, because any number to the 0 power is 1. So we'll have a y-intercept at 0, 1. Okay, let's take that information and just do a rough graph. We know where the horizontal asymptote is, that's along the x-axis. We know we've got a point at 0, 1. And if we had another point, we could probably sketch this graph. So let's figure out what happens when x equals 1. Well, when x is 1, 0.5 to the first power is going to be 0.5. So when x is 1, I'll have a point at 1, 0.5. Notice that when x is 1, you're going to have a point at 1, and then whatever the base happens to be, because any base number raised to the first power is just going to be that base. Okay, so I've got these two points. I know where the horizontal asymptote is. I know how this curves. So I'm just going to put in a rough sketch of the graph. It'll look something like that. Okay, now I want to look at transformations of this basic function. So I've got a neater graph here with all the x and y coordinates. And let's look at a vertical transformation. Let's try y equals, we'll take that same 0.5 to the x and just say 0.5 to the x plus 1. By adding a 1 after the exponential function, the exponential expression, what I'm going to do is take this original graph, this red one, and just raise everything up by 1 unit. So I'm going to have a point at 1, 2, of a point at 0, 2, of a point at 1, 1.5. I'll have a horizontal asymptote at y equals 1. I had a point here at negative 1, 2, so I'll have another point at negative 1, 3, and then I can take those points, sketch in that graph, and it's just raised everything up by 1 unit. Okay, so that's vertical translations or vertical shifts. If I add a positive number after the exponential expression, it raises everything up. If I'd had a negative number, it would drop everything down. Okay, we can also stretch this. So let's try y equals 2 times 0.5 to the x. That 2 as a coefficient is going to take all of my y values and double them. It's going to stretch the graph. So I'll have a point at 0, 2, at 1, 1, negative 1, 4. I'll have the same horizontal asymptote. I'm just going to have a graph that's stretched out more than the original, stretched out more vertically. Okay, so that's what that coefficient does. If I'd had a negative sign in front of it, I made that negative 2, what that would do is not only stretch it, but it would also flip it over. So I'd have a graph that, let's see, went down like this. Okay, it stretched it and it's flipped it. It's reflected it across the x-axis. Okay, so besides vertical shifts and stretches and reflections, we can also do some horizontal ones. So if I have y equals 0.5, and let's take that and raise that to the x minus 2, that minus 2 is going to shift the entire graph horizontally 2 units over to the right. Like a lot of transformations you've already seen, if I add a negative number after the x, it shifts the graph over that many units to the right. If I have a positive number after the x, it shifts the graph that many units over to the left. So we're going to shift this graph 2 units over to the right, which means I'll have a point at 2, 1, 3, 1 half, 1, 2. The horizontal asymptote is going to be the same. And the graph looks something like that. Okay, so that's vertical translations or horizontal translations or horizontal shifts. I can also reflect the graph horizontally. To do that, all I'm going to do is put a negative sign in front of the exponent. That's going to take the graph and flip it, reflect it across the y-axis. Okay, and now, as with other transformations you've seen, we can take these and combine them. So we can do something like y equals 2 times 0.5 to the x plus 2 minus 4. Okay, let's get an idea of what that's going to do. This x plus 2 is going to take the graph and shift it horizontally. That plus 2 is going to shift it over to the left by 2 units. The coefficient 2 is going to stretch it vertically by a factor of 2. And the negative 4, the minus 4 at the end, is going to drop everything down, which means I'm going to have a horizontal asymptote at y equals negative 4. Now what I find is the easiest way to do this, because they can get kind of confusing, is to make a small table of values and just find a couple of points. So what I want to do is figure out how I could get this whole exponent, x plus 2, to equal 0, since that would be a nice power to raise this 0.5 to. So if I make the x into negative 2, then the whole exponent equals 0. I'll have negative 2 plus 2, which is 0. So I've got 0.5 raised to the 0 power, which is just a 1. I'm going to multiply that by 2, so that'll be 2. Then I'll subtract 4, so that's going to be negative 2. So I'm going to have a point at negative 2, comma, negative 2. Let's go on to negative 1. If x is negative 1, then I've got 0.5 to the negative 1 plus 2, or 0.5 to the first power, which is just 0.5. When I multiply that by 2, 2 times 0.5, it's the same as 2 times 1 half, I get just a 1, and 1 minus 4 is negative 3. So I'm going to have another point at negative 1, comma, negative 3. that would be over here. I know my graph is curving downwards, and I know where the horizontal asymptote is. So I can take those two points and sketch in a rough curve to get a general idea of what this is going to look like. Okay, that's about it. Take care. I'll see you next time.